I got the cash in the bag, stadium packed. Born a rock star in this life, gonna live it up on the attack. Baby, I'm bad. I just wanna get caught up in this life. I'm crazy, I'm mad. Doing no cap. Only God wants you, better go live it up. Cash in the bag, stadium packed. Baby, I'm bad. Yeah. Baby, I'm bad.
I just wanna stay bad, stay mad. Chip on my shoulder, cause they treat me like an outcast. I ain't gonna take that, stay back. I'll be swinging hard till the hits come in all caps. I ain't gonna lay back, pray that someone's gonna help me. Ain't nobody like that. I ain't gonna wait, that's all fact. Give me one shot and I'll never get the throne back. I'm sick of being cautious. I'ma go cause some pain, can't stop this. I'ma steal everybody's lane, call it shoplift. Sick of hearing everyone complain when they thoughtless. Taste the pain, it's like candy canes. It makes me go change into a better frame, into a better name. Society's insane, we all live for fame, yeah.
Welcome back to Frank's Model Aviation Workshop. This is part 4 in the Carl Goldberg Tiger II build series. In this episode, we're going to be finishing up the wing, installing the wing tips, beveling the ailerons, and getting the aileron linkages and stuff in the center of the wing. We'll get that finished, get this episode done, and then we'll be on to the fuselage. If you like this type of content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Hit that notification bell so that you can be notified of future episodes of the build. And be sure to like and share my videos. I'd really appreciate it. Let's get going. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is draw a center line on the wingtips, both of them. And then I'm going to draw a center line on the trailing edge because I'm going to have to hinge it anyway. So that way I can line my tip to the trailing edge and the leading edge. It already has that flashing from the from where the two leading edges were joined together. So we'll do that, and then we'll glue the tip trailing edge on, and then we'll proceed from there. Okay, we'll just get the center on here. Hopefully I can get that in there. These aren't really perfect, so you just get it close. That'll be the left one.
and the right.
So now I'll run this Carl Goldberg centerline gauge down the trailing edge, and that'll get me my center line for that. Actually, I need it on the end here. For now. Well, I got the center line gauge out. I'm going to go ahead and mark the trailing edge on the wing for my hinge locations off of the plan, because I don't like to put that groove all the way down the trailing edge of the wing, because it shows through the Monaco, even though you won't see it once it's all hinged up, but that's just a pet peeve of mine. Okay. And I'll go ahead and centerline that as well. Okay, I darkened up the mark for my trailing edge on the wing, and I got my line here. I'm just going to line that up, making sure I got enough on the back side here for my trailing edge piece. So I'm going to go ahead and put medium CA on here on the wing tip, and then we'll line it up using the thickest part of the wing as a gauge, and then I'll just kind of hard to get a good angle on this, but I'll just adjust this until it's centered on that line. So that's what I'll be doing, in case you can't see what I'm doing. I'll reposition the camera. Gonna have to put in an order for some medium CA because I'm running out. I like to kind of steer clear of the very edge of it to avoid a hard sand joint, but put enough on there to where it will glue the wingtip on securely. Now here's the trick. Make sure you get it the right way. Okay, I'll bring you around to show you how I got it lined up. So I got it flush with the center of the wing, and I just lined up that line with the center line. Now, once I've glued that trailing edge piece on here, I'll trim this off and then trim it off the leading edge here, and then we'll razor plane it to the shape of the wing. But that's what I'll do on the other side too. And then after I get the other side glued on, we'll glue those tips in. There's the right wing tip. And the left wing tip. Now we'll go ahead and glue those trailing edge tip pieces on both sides.
One thing I forgot to mention, which I probably should have, is the plans or the instructions say to sand this trailing edge flush, so those trailing edge sheets are flush with the trailing edge, and also to sand the tip flush before you glue these tips on. Forgot to mention that, so had to do that first before we did all that. So we'll continue with gluing these tips on. Okay, so now we'll proceed to glue these trailing edge tip pieces on using medium CA. This end grain tends to absorb glue, so I put a little bit of extra on there. I always like to test fit before I glue. Next step is to rough sand or rough shape the trailing edge pieces, or the trailing edge tips, not the trailing edge, what am I talking about? The wing tips. And I like to use these cheapo Harbor Freight moving blankets to do all my rough work on my table, so to avoid any hanger rash. So these are really cheap. If you can get them on sale for like less than $7 at Harbor Freight whenever they go on sale, but that was a Black Friday purchase. I had one earlier, but I don't know what happened to it, but got another one. So we'll go ahead and we'll shape these up. I'll do that in fast speed. So one thing to note, you notice as I'm sanding using this permagrit, I'm holding it over my ribs here, the cap strips, but I'm not putting any pressure on these cap strips at all. I'm just kind of just riding on the wingtip because I don't want to like sand through my cap strips. That would kind of irritate me a little bit. So I'm avoiding the cap strips. I'm just taking it down to the very end cap strip. And I'm not going to sand this end until I get my aileron hinged and placed. That way I can have a straighter area to sand with my sanding bar. Anyway, back to fast speed. Okay, so there's the top. I'm gonna leave this protruding here until I get my aileron hinged up. That way when I go to sand that off, I got a straighter edge and I won't have any kind of deviation on the tip. Because if you sand it now, it's either gonna be angled that way or your trailing edge tip is gonna be angled this way, and that'll end up making your trailing edge look like crap.
So I'm gonna flip this over. This edge here is kind of, it's thin, but I'm gonna like slightly round that. Not overly round, just to, I wanna keep it semi-sharp. And I'm gonna harden that with some thin CA before I cover it. That way it'll be a nice and sharp finish. But there's a slight deviation here, which will be filled with balsa filler. It's kind of from here to here. It's like an imperfection in the trailing edge. But we'll get that filled before we do any covering. We're a little bit ways from that. So let's flip this over and do the other side. Okay, there's the finished, it's not really final sanded, but it's to where I need to do the fine sanding. A little bit of filler right here. But I'm happy with the way it turned out. You know, the sawing, there's saw marks on this from the factory, so I'm gonna have to smooth that out. But here's what I was talking about. That's as sharp as I wanna make it. It's got just a slight round that I'll harden once I get this sanded. I'll harden that edge so it'll protect it a little. I mean, it's not gonna be perfect, but at least it'll keep it from getting any more round when I'm covering. So I'll do the other tip off camera and then we'll head to the next step, which is doing the aileron linkages, the controls, and these center sections. And there's the finished right wing tip, except for this area. Like I said, I'm gonna hinge the ailerons first before I finish sanding that trailing edge. So I got both wing tips looking pretty snazzy. I like it. All right, next step is we're gonna bend those wires for the ailerons and I'll set the camera up and get back to it. Okay, so we gotta install or bend these up, these aileron control linkages. They go like this on the plans. So I'm gonna line it up here. And as you can see, if I bend it there, I'm gonna have a good inch go into the aileron, which is better than that 3/8 of an inch right there. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna work backwards. Instead of gluing these, I could bend these up, but instead of gluing these on first before I cut the ailerons, I'm gonna go ahead and line the wing up to the plan, measure off the aileron, and cut it to length. And I'm gonna drill this out on the drill press so that I got a nice, clean, straight hole. And I think that'll take care with it. Having an inch of that push rod into the aileron will take care of most of that aileron flutter that these Tiger 2s get at times. So we'll see how that goes. I'll set up the camera and we'll start making some measurements and doing some cutting. So whatever I do on one side, I'm going to duplicate on the other side so that if you look at the plane, it's going to look symmetrical would be the word. Identical, both sides will be the same. So I'm just lining up that wing tip. And then I'm just gonna place my aileron on here. I'll tell you what I'm gonna do first. I'll extend that. I'm gonna extend this line here. that I can see it. I think I want a 30 seconds inch gap. Scratch that. I'm going to go with the 16th. So we'll line this up again. I'm just using a 16th balsa. And that looks like a good gap. So we'll just mark this. That'll be my aileron. Now, before I go on to the other side, I'll make sure I keep these all together because those are a kit. I'm going to go to the other side, do the same thing over there. Okay. That's that. The ailerons are cut to shape. Let's see how close we are with the center sections. I'm just squaring off these center sections now. So I'm marking the center section where these two come together. Always measure twice and cut once. What I'm doing is matching the dihedral. That should be perfect. All right, now I'll do the same to the other side. This is a matching pair. We'll put the other part right here. Let's see. pretty dang good to me. So that's that. Ailerons, centerpieces are cut. Now we can accurately put this aileron where it needs to be on the plan. Mark where I need to drill the hole, both of them, and then go put it on the drill press and hopefully drill them perfectly perpendicular. And the way I'll drill them is I'll place them like this. Make sure these are 90, like that. And drill the hole down through. Of course, that's, never mind, I'm drilling the wrong thing. The ailerons, whenever I mark the ailerons, I'll place the ailerons like that, opposite, so I have a more steady and straight drill. So we'll see how that works. So, we're done with the saw. I'll need that for the drill press. So now I'm going to mark for my push rod hole, because I'm going to bend it exactly where it's at. So I'm going to go ahead and line this up again. Hold the aileron right there. Extend these out. Takes forever to, when you're trying to achieve perfection, you may not even get perfection when you try. That'll be close enough. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to mark both those lines as the width of that push rod. And I'm using my square to extend them out the whole way. And there's the width of the push rod. And when I run my bevel gauge, or you know, my center line gauge down here, that'll get me my center for that. So that's the right aileron. That will do the same thing for the left side. Keep forgetting. Let me extend that out. Alright, there's that one. Now it uses the tool. We gotta do that anyway to achieve our center line. Okay, now what I was saying is I'll place these like that on the drill press, and I'm going to use this as my gauge for 90, so I know that, well, maybe they're not, it won't be 90, got to figure something out here. How am I going to... can almost feel the flat on that side. They're pretty thick. How am I going to achieve? Well, I'm gonna get the drill press set up first, then I'll be back. Okay, so I saw my dilemma of, I was going to do this against it, but it won't be 90. So, I've got 3/16 square, and I'll put that against it. And that will get me my 90. We'll double check here. Oh, that's nice. Luckily it didn't hurt the bowl, so. Yeah, that'll get me my 90. So we'll go drill some holes. So I got a piece of tape marking 1 inch, so I don't want to go any further in than 1 inch. So I'm going to use this back here. Hopefully this is going to work. I'm going to get as close to the wood as I can get. This is going to be a trick. I'm gonna have to raise my table. Yeah. As you can see, you're not gonna see what's going on, so I'm going to do this off camera. But it's set up perpendicular, and I'm gonna go ahead and drill this, and then I'll show you the result. Okay, there's the result. I'll show you that it's perpendicular once I get out there. As you can see, it's perfectly perpendicular. So now all I gotta do is bend that at an exact 90 degrees. Okay, got both sides drilled. Now we're gonna put together these things that have the rod support, and this brass rod needs to be cut to the end of the aileron trailing edge, or the inner trailing edge. So I'll line it up with the push rod. I'm gonna measure that and cut it. And then we'll get ready to bend this 90 here. I'm just deburring this. Make sure this. You want to make sure that goes on smooth. So that should be a perfect cut. Yep, just where I wanted it. So now I gotta hold that at 90 degrees. I think I'll do that by taping it to that. Okay, I placed my mark on the outside of where that push rod's going in because I'm going to bend this part down. And when I put my pliers on there, I'm going to leave the line plus just a little when I bend that. Scratch that. I need to redo that mark. I'm going to place the mark on this second line here. That line. Because I'm going to grab this small section with my pliers and bend the big side. It'll be easier. Then it should fit there perfectly. We'll see. Hopefully I don't screw this up. It's been a while since I've done this plan. All right, let's think this through. That's gotta be 90, it's gotta come this way. So let's line this up first. And what I'm doing, I'm sighting down to make sure that that's 90 degrees or straight to the pliers, and it's 90 degrees or perpendicular to the pliers. And then I'm gonna bend this side toward me. I messed it up. Nope. I got her on the first try, amazingly enough. Want that 90 to be as sharp as you can get. It's kind of tough with these pliers like that, but what I'm doing is just making sure that threaded section is 90 degrees to the plan. I don't have much confidence in this wire. All right, that's 90 degrees to the plan. Now let's put this into the aileron and see what it looks like. That's perfect. Okay, that's perfect. I'm happy with that. I'm gonna leave that just like that for now. We'll repeat the process for the left side. Okay, there we have it. We got a matching set of control push rods, horns, aileron control, whatever you want to call it. Now, next step. I got to cut the notch in here and glue these in. I got to also embed these in there. So that'll be my next step. So I'm going to have to break out some epoxy apparently. So we'll get that set up and get this part done. Okay, so I'm not going to go by the plans and use their measurements for where to put the notch, because I deviated from it from doing the rest of this aileron trailing edge area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my 16th inch gap here like this. And then I'll just mark on the other side where that push rod is going to need beveled. And then that's where it'll exactly be. And I'll have my exact 16th inch gap. Of course, I just moved that, so. But that's how that'll work. So I already marked this side. So I'll get this side marked, and I'm gonna use my permagrit needle file for cutting that. And we'll get her going. I'll set up the camera. I'll just take this and slowly make my bevel. I'm marking where this hinge thing or whatever this is called is gonna go in. That'll be notched out inside here. Okay, I already got that notched out. I'll have to recess this part a little bit deeper, but as you can see, I got my notch made. Way too much throw there, but I'd rather have a little bit more than for it to bind. So that'll be neutral right there. That'll work. I'll do the other side. Okay, there's one side fitted. I got my 16th inch gap, which once it's glued up, it'll be straight. So that's that. Now I'll do the right side.
I think I'll do that on camera, I guess.
Okay, I'm gonna start off by starting this belt, this notch here. I want to make it semi-identical to the other side. And because this wire has a curve in it, I got to cut a little relief right here. And now I gotta mark that dealio. I like these Hobby Co. Hinge slotters. I've tried these, and boy, I really screwed up many a hinge slot with those things. But these Hobby Co. ones seem to be the most accurate, in my opinion. They leave a nicer slot, too. So I just eyeball it. And then as I'm hinging it, you want to make sure that's perpendicular. You just move that back and forth. And you change this out for this little hook clean out deal. And you just go in there and clean that slot out, because it's not going to clean it totally. Or you're not going to slot it totally. So you get in there with this slotter or this clean out tool and clean out the center section. This doesn't have to be absolutely perfect, because it's gonna just slide down in there anyway. So there. So that's that. Now I need to cut the slot for that. So I just do that with an X-Acto knife. I'm cutting the chamfer or the round for that push rod, because it's not a perfect 90. Or it's not a square 90, I should say. And we'll test fit. There you have it. All right, next step. I'm gonna recess these nylon things in a little bit further. Got to figure out how I want to do that. I think I'm just gonna use the X-Acto. Went to try to get new X-Acto blades, and all they didn't have the cheapo 100 pack like I usually buy for $20. They had the X-Acto name brand, which was $5 for 5 blades, so I passed that up. I ain't paying $5 for 5 blades. All right, let's see how that fits. That should be perfect. Yep. That's nice. That'll work. And I don't think I'll have any aileron flutter on this. That's pretty dang good. So now what I'm going to do, I think I'm going to epoxy these on with my 16th inch with my 16th inch gap there. And I'll epoxy these on. Before I epoxy them though, I'm going to finish the other side. Almost lost my battery, so I'm going to recess this other one now. Oh yeah. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna rough up this tube and this, and I need to find some Vaseline so I don't epoxy my rod shut. So be right back. Okay, I'm just gonna rough this up a little bit just so the epoxy has something to stick to. I might even use CA for this. Epoxy that nylon thing in there. Either way, I have to rough this up anyway. Found my Vaseline. Okay. All right, so now I want to make sure I get some Vaseline down in there. I don't want it to get in my hinge. Might even help lube the pivot. Okay. That one's prepped. Okay, we'll set up to epoxy this. This is 30 minute. Just eyeball it. All right, that's that side. All right. We'll let that set up, and then I'll take the ailerons off, then we'll glue these on. And we have to notch the top side for the push rods. Be back in a minute. Okay, so I went ahead and I put a little recess where these are gonna go, just so it'll sit on there nice and I don't have anything rocking back and forth. And now we need to put that same groove in the wing. I just want to make it to where I have it deep enough to where I have an even throw both ways. So that's good. That's way more than I need. So that one's good. That one's good. Okay, now we'll glue these on. Lining them up, and I'm going to use medium CA. Being careful not to get any glue. You probably didn't see a dang thing I just showed you. Made a groove in here, just to, in case there's any protruding on my trailing edge here. And then I finished off the groove where the aileron push rods are gonna connect, just so that I have an even amount of play or even amount of throw. And I do. So now we'll set up and glue this on. I'm going to use medium CA. Be careful you don't glue your your hands down to the success. Any gaps or any deviations you can just fill or sand out. It's no big deal. And if you want to test fit your aileron for your gap, it's still there. And that one's on. Now here's the trick. Glue this one on and get some glue in the center here too. Okay, that was easy. All right, next step is to bevel the ailerons because I already got them notched out. Oh yeah, perfect. Okay, so I like that. That'll work. Let's get rid of some of the stuff that's going to cause hangar rash. All right. I think I'm going to need to make a different bevel tool. This one will work, I'll use it. Yeah, it's different. Okay, I gotta make a new bevel tool. Be back with that. Okay, so here's the deal. I don't know what I did with my other beveling tool. I checked my plywood die cut sheet or laser cut sheet. And I think this is the only one I got. But the ailerons aren't beveled as severe as the, like if I use the elevator and rudder beveling tool on the aileron, it's going to really make it a deep V. So I'm going to eyeball about that angle. Yeah, I'm going to be showing you. I'm going to eyeball about that angle because that's the actual angle that the bevel will be. And I kind of got an idea. What I'll do is I'll tape a piece of, maybe some 3/16 right there along that where it's going to ride the beveling tool. And that way I'll have the correct angle. So that's what I'll do when I go to bevel. So we'll get set up and do the beveling in fast speed. This is going to take a while to set up, but I'll show you how I'm going to do it. So I've got the aileron stuff there. And here's my 3/16 piece. So I'll take this, put it on the edge there, and that will be my bevel. So I'll tape this 3/16 sheet down right there. Seems like a big hassle, but I want the bevel to be correct. Yeah. Okay, so now get my razor plane back out. What sucks is I gotta do this to both sides. I'll eyeball that.
What they do, they'll put a sharp blade in this thing. I'll check my bevel. You always want to double check. When you do airplanes, you want to be able to adapt and overcome to any situations like me not having the correct bevel, but you want to get the correct bevel, you got to improvise. You know what I forgot to do? I forgot to slot. So we're gonna pause this until I slot that. Dang it. Alright, slotted. Back to sanding. That was a close call. I'll take that for now.
Now we got to set up and do the same thing on the other side.
And there we have one left side aileron hinged and beveled. Now we'll get the other side done. I'll do that off camera. And then we'll finish. Oh, I wanted to say, I went ahead and, since I had the ailerons hinged up or ready, I went ahead and sanded that smooth. So that's lined up. So I'll get ready and do the other side. Then I'll bring you back and show you what it looks like. All right, we got the left side beveled and hinged. The right side beveled and hinged. Last thing to do is this nylon tape that goes down the center here. And after that's done, we're on to the fuselage. We're getting close. Fuselage should be a quickie. Anyway, I'll get set up and we'll do that center reinforcement tape. Okay, the instructions say to final sand the wing before I put that fiberglass tape in the center. I'm not going to do that yet. I final sanded the center section where the tape's going to go because it's going to be a long process to final sand this wing before I can go on to the fuselage. And I want to go on to the fuselage. So I'm going to go ahead and put this tape on now, and next episode, we'll start the fuselage. I'll final sand everything before I cover it. I think that'll be a better way of doing it, because that way I can really see where I need to final sand, you know, for real. So anyway, I got it final sanded all along this section, about 2 inches out from the center. So we'll go ahead and put that fiberglass tape on, and then I'm going to call this episode 4 finished. Okay, I like to do this center tape, you know, on my lap, so I'm gonna do it like this. Prepping my finger for the CA. Back in the day, I wouldn't use tape, I just do the CA with my finger, didn't really care. Let's try to do this without banging up my wing too much. So I'm going to start it first. Try to get it to where you guys can see what's going on. really want to saturate that tape. This stuff really burns the eyes. Try not to get any CA down in them holes, that would suck. I like to go back through and put a second coat on. That way I can make sure my eyes are really burning. That's it. Well, that'll do it for episode 4. I hope you guys and gals, if there is any gals watching this, enjoy what you're seeing, learn something from it, and maybe take some ideas out of it. And I'm really enjoying it. We're almost done with this thing. We got the wing finished, and we're going to go on to the fuselage next. So if you like this type of content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Be sure to hit that notification bell so that you can be notified of future episodes. And hit that like and share my videos. I really appreciate it. So until next episode, thanks for watching.